Welcome back to News Plus, everyone. I'm Mark Seagraves. We're joined now by former Mayor Vincent Gray, now Citizen Gray. Mayor Gray, you have been on this show. I would be remiss if I didn't remind viewers that you were actually our very first guest on News Plus more than 6 years ago.
That's right.
Back when you were on the DC Council.
Yep.
I will say that that you prognosticated at the time that by this time I would have made it to the network and you would have been in the White House, but wrong on both counts, but neither one of us is done yet, so welcome back. We appreciate you coming in. This is the first time, though, that I have ever interviewed Citizen Gray. Right now, you are in your retirement years, enjoying your house in Ward 7. But a lot has happened since you left office. And so I just want to spend a couple of minutes on the investigation, and then we can move forward. As everybody probably knows, the U.S. Attorney's Office had a multi-year investigation into your 2010 campaign. They called it a shadow campaign. Several people pled guilty, some of them who were close to you over the years. Right before your re-election night, right before when you were running for re-election, just months before the election, the U.S. Attorney at the time, Ron Machen, had a press conference. And as Jack Evans, who sat in this chair talking to me not too long ago, said, all but told the voting public that you were about to be indicted.
Mm-hmm.
Years go by, you lost that election. Many believe because a lot of people thought you were about to be indicted. Years go by, and a few months ago, U.S. Attorney now Channing Phillips, Ron Machen has since moved on, announces there will be no charges. The case is closed, no one else will be charged, and there will be absolutely no charges against Vince Gray. Your reaction to what that put you through and what that put the voters of the District of Columbia through?
Well, you know, I maintained all along, Mark, consistently. You were there for, you know, a lot of those interactions, and I said right from the very beginning, this is not something that I know anything about. And, you know, the U.S. Attorney's Office continued to leak information wherever they possibly could to people. You know, and then to hear that, you know, the investigation is being ended. First of all, it was relief, you know, and I appreciate what U.S. Attorney Channing Phillips did to go in 6 weeks to look at what was there and close this case down. But there's also an enormous amount of anger and resentment associated with this, Mark, because we were ahead in virtually every poll that had been taken, and then this press conference was held. We were up by anywhere from 8 to 13 points, and there was nobody that I know of that had any significant complaints about the kind of job that we were doing in the city. I think it had the impact, frankly, of essentially sending the message to people that Gray is going to be charged, he's going to be indicted. And there were people who said, well, I don't want to vote for any of these other candidates, and I'm not going to vote for him if he's about to be indicted. And if you look at the turnout, it was significantly suppressed by this news, in my opinion. All you have to do is look at the turnout in, you know, Ward 7, 8, 5, significantly below the turnout in 2010 and 2014, because I think people just said, you know, why bother? I don't want to vote for the rest of these folks, so I'm just not going to vote. So, you know, as I look back on it, I think we were deprived of an opportunity to continue a job that I absolutely loved doing. I'm a native Washingtonian. I love doing things for my city. And we should have had the opportunity to be able to continue, Mark.
Have you talked to or heard from Ron Machen?
Oh, no, absolutely not.
And is your anger directed toward him, toward the system?
It's largely him. He's the one that held the press conference. He's the one that was conducting this investigation. What in the world could possibly have taken so long? It's not complicated. I mean, it's either this guy knew about this guy was involved in this, or he wasn't. And where was the information? We had people in the media saying, listen, they've interrogated, you know, everybody possible, and there's nothing else there that they can even ask them. And they didn't do anything further about it. You know, again, it took a new U.S. attorney to come in there in order to be able to end this thing.
It took two.
Yeah,
because there was one in between Ron Machen. And
well, he was the
interim.
But
well,
he was involved in this case, to be honest.
Well,
you're talking
Phillips
about Cohen.
Is, yeah.
Cohen, he was involved in this. And frankly, I don't know why he didn't get the job, because he was trying to get it. But I honestly believe that You know, he was asked during the interview process, what do you got, man? What is taking so long? I don't think they had anything to say. Clearly, they had nothing to say substantively with respect to me. So what could they produce at this stage? They hired somebody else. They hired Channing Phillips, who came in there and looked at this situation, and in 6 weeks said enough is enough.